I'm Ahmed Bashad. I'm the director of the Johns Hopkins Center for Fetal Therapy, and in the following short video clip, I will run through the key steps to successful laser surgery for twin-twin transfusion syndrome. The first key step to successful laser surgery is gaining access to the uterine sac of the recipient. This is done in most of the times under local anesthetic. Once we are in the sac of the recipient, we will identify the cord insertion of the recipient, as you see here in the middle of the picture. And from there, we will follow the vessels that run on the placenta and selectively identify those that connect with the donor twin that you can see now here. The white line that now comes into the image is the membrane in the donor twin that's draped over the placenta because that baby has no fluid left. Once we identify these vessels, we will then bring in the laser fiber and coagulate them until they're completely white, so we are sure there is no blood flow between the two twins. And then at the end of the procedure, we will also laser along the line of the vascular equator, which is the natural dividing line between the two twins, and then drain the fluid in the sac of the recipient so that it is normal. Typically, the fluid and bladder filling returns back to normal within 2 weeks after the laser procedure, and the patients can return to the referring obstetricians.